Hey there, folks. So, a bit something different today. My best friend Alice has requested some cooking tips, so I thought I'd give her a hand. Hi, Alice. So, for my first ever cooking video, I am going to show you how to do my favourite starter of breaded brie. So, main ingredient, some nice brie slices there. And you'll also need some plain flour, breadcrumbs, and one lightly mixed egg whisk. That's the word I was looking for. So what we're going to do is we are going to take the first slice. And it's a really easy, simple thing to do. And before I actually show you, you need to preheat your oil in a pan. Deep fat fryer is probably a lot easier, but I don't have one of those, so I'm just going to use a frying pan with some vegetable oil, which has been preheated on a high heat. Don't burn it. Make sure you don't smoke your house out. So let's start. So you just get your slice of brie, dunk it in your lightly whisked egg. Step one. Step two, take your plain flour and dip your now egg-covered brie into there. Make sure it's nicely covered. It's gonna get sticky, it's gonna get messy. If you don't like mess, I don't recommend it. Now, step three, cover it in some more egg. This will give it a nice coating of flour, eggs. And your last and final stage, dip it in your breadcrumbs, which I've actually pre-measured out in bowls here. I'm not very specific with measurements, so just chuck in what I think will be enough. Now, using your dry hand, try and cover this whole thing in breadcrumbs, making sure it's all covered. By the end of it, it should be nicely covered and looking like this. Set this aside. Depending on how many portions you want to do, I would say two slices per portion is adequate enough. Just depends how much you like cheese and how hungry you are. So, second slice. Again, you start with the egg. Make sure it's all covered evenly so everything will stick. Step two, can you remember that, folks? It's flour straight in there. See, all my hands are a mess now. Back to the egg. Sure, it's all nicely covered. I like mine very well covered. I think one egg's enough really for 2-3 portions. Don't need that much. Again, once that's covered, shake off the excess straight into the breadcrumbs. Make sure that's nicely covered. Doesn't matter if you miss any patches, you know, cheese is made to melt and brie's got that natural cover anyway on it that sort of seals all the gooiness inside, the gooey goodness. And then once that's done, make sure it's all covered, you can set that aside. Now make sure you wash your hands afterwards, get all that shit off your hands, excuse the language. This out the way. So my brie is good to go. So move this over here. See my pre-boiled pan of hot oil, so always be careful when handling hot oil. And in this instance, get myself a pair of tongs and you'll hear the nice sizzling noise when you know when this is ready. Straight in. As I said, ideally it's better with a deep fat fryer. Get it all covered in. But I don't have one, so I'll have to make do. Make sure you rotate it evenly. Taylor Swift in the background. leave that there to cook. There's a couple of things you can serve this with. The way I prefer it is with a side of chili jam poured on top, on the side, whatever you like. You can get some nice creamy strawberry compotes that you can do. I have tried it with strawberry fromage frais before. Very nice, don't knock it till you try it. So I am debating trying this with either some cranberry sauce or some strawberry yogurt. Now you can see the cheese is starting to melt through. Make sure you get all of it cooked through. Smells divine, not gonna lie. Now, I don't have a fancy salad prepped or anything to go with this. Literally just gonna be the cheese and the sauce, which I think I will do as cranberry sauce today. All set. So once it starts getting a nice golden dark brown colour, it's starting to get close to it being ready to eat. It's really that simple. So turn that heat off. Not a fan of electric hobs or electric ovens, but the beauty of them is if you want to retain the heat, it does hold the heat in a fairly long time. So I'm going to give it another 20 seconds and then it should be done. There, it's probably done now. So I'm going to use some paper towel to set mine on for the time being. Just soak up that excess oil, get a nice crispy finish on it. I'm going to take that off the heat, gently removing that and placing it on the paper towel. As you can see there, we've got really nice melted cheese on there. Got the presentation plate ready. Now that oil's gone off there, we'll place that on here. Right, and then just serve it with your chosen condiment. Brie and cranberry are ideal together. Normally you can have, I think my favourite sandwich is bacon, brie and cranberry. There you have it, folks. And then you just tuck in. I'll just get that close up for you, bear with me. Easy as that. I hope you've enjoyed my semi-educational video on how to make breaded brie. Leave a comment below. Come and find your love.